بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ramadan Mubarak to you and to your family. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with the month of Ramadan, the month of taqwa, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see at the end of the month of Ramadan and throughout the month of Ramadan that you gain and achieve taqwa. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All those who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordained and prescribed upon you fasting the way He did on the previous nations before you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you could acquire taqwa, so you could increase your taqwa, so you could advance in your taqwa. So the month of Ramadan is not only the month of fasting, and not only the month of reading the Quran Kareem, and not only the month of praise, but it is the month of taqwa. And what's taqwa? Taqwa does not necessarily mean that you only increase in your ibadat, but before you increase in your ibadat, keep away from the haram. Abstaining away from the haram. That's why the Prophet Muhammad says to one of the Sahaba, اتَّقِ الْمَحَارِمَ تَكُنْ أَعْبَدَ النَّاسِ. Refrain and abstain away from the haram, you'll become the greatest worshipper. So taqwa is not necessarily that we increase in our salah and increase in our recitation of the Quran Kareem and increase our fasting, increase our donation. That's part of taqwa. But before increasing from the good worships and the great worships and the rituals, you have to abstain away from the haram. So the month of Ramadan is about keeping away from the haram, for us to gain taqwa, for us to acquire taqwa. Keep away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forbidden. And part of taqwa is not that you keep away from the haram in the month of Ramadan, then you go back to the haram after the month of Ramadan. Part of the true taqwa that you gain out of the month of Ramadan, that you abstain away from the haram in the month of Ramadan, and you keep away from the haram after the month of Ramadan. That's also a part of taqwa and steadfastness. So, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All those who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed upon you fasting, and then at the end Allah says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you could gain taqwa out of your fasting. And that's one important objective that you want to aim for, that you gain taqwa in the month of Ramadan. Increase your iman in the month of Ramadan, and strengthen your taqwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by keeping away from the haram, by keeping away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden. And had there someone disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing that Allah azza wa jalla is watching him, that's not taqwa. Where's the fear of Allah azza wa jalla in our lives? Part of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you do not disobey Allah azza wa jalla and commit the sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen your taqwa and make us from amongst those that achieve taqwa in the month of Ramadan. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Every Muslim dreams to be up in Jannah. A pious person's destiny. Inshallah, in Jannah.